Welcome to Homeopathic Pharmacy Academia. In this video lecture, I am going to explain about liquid vehicle distilled water. We know distilled water is an important liquid vehicle used in homeopathic pharmacy. Let us see the method of preparation, properties, and various uses of distilled water. The synonym of distilled water is aqua distillata or aqua purificata or purified water. The chemical formula of distilled water is H2O. Molecular weight is 18. And now we'll discuss about preparation of distilled water. To prepare small scale quantity of distilled water, there are two methods. One is distillation method. The other one is deionization method. Large scale preparations, automatic water distillator is a method. Now let us see the distillation method. The distillation method, in distillation method, the ordinary water is taken in a round bottom distillation flask and keep it on a wire gauge over a tripod stand, and it should be clamped properly. The distillation flask is attached firmly to one end of Liebig's condenser and the other end is connected to a receiving flask. Now the distillation flask is closed with a rubber cork and a thermometer is inserted to a cork to measure the temperature of water vapor. And now heat the distillation flask with a Bunsen burner, a few boiling chips or glass beads are kept on a flask to prevent the bumping of the water. And once it is heated, the water boils and the vapor from distillation flask enters to Liebig's condenser and gets cooled and converted into water. And this pure distilled water, which is free from all physical impurities, is collected in the receiving flask. And this is a process of simple distillation process or method, which is used to prepare distilled water in small scale. Now, let us see the deionization process. Deionization or demineralized water is a water from which all cation and anion of electrolytes have to be removed. It is prepared by treatment of water with a cation exchanger in the acid or hydrogen form. All cations of electrolytes are replaced by hydrogen ions. The deionized or acidified water is then treated with an anion exchanger in the basic or hydroxide form. The resultant water obtained is pure and deionized. Now let us see in detail about deionization process. So I told you there are two types of ion exchange resins. One is cation exchange resin, and another one is anion exchange resins. In cation exchange resin, as I told, hydrogen ion is present, and in anion exchange resin, hydroxyl ion is present. The commercially available cation exchange resins are zeocarb 225, amberlite IR 120, and the commercially available anion exchange resin, amberlite IR 400, D-acetate FF, and zeolite FF. So these are the commercially available cation exchange resin and anion exchange resins. Now, the process of deionization. The mineralized water, that is the water which contain the impure water which contain minerals, several minerals like calcium or magnesium, are passed through the cation exchange resin, where these ions, earth metallic ions, are replaced by hydrogen. So the anions like calcium or magnesium are replaced by hydrogen ion or acid ion. Then the acid was water without these ions are passed through anion exchange resin, where these anions are of acid replaced by OH, that is hydroxyl ion. So once the anions of acids are replaced by OH ion, it becomes pure demineralized water. So thus we obtain the demineralized pure water. This is the picture or image of demineralized water plant. We can see two exchange resins here, anion exchange resins and cation exchange resins. Now about automatic water distillator. So this is used for large scale distillation of water. The distillation vessel is known as still. And in this method, the distillation and cooling is done by same water. The water is get into heating chamber through some holes, and the steam thus produced is passing through the inner chamber and get cooled, and distilled water is produced. So in this method is adopted for a large scale commercial production of purified water. And in this process, the same water is used to distill and for cooling. That is a specialty of automatic water distillation. So the still consists of an outer heating chamber and an inner cooling chamber. When impure water enters the heating chamber, it cools, it gets boiled, and steam is produced. And this steam passes through the inner cooling chamber and get it cooled. The purified water thus obtained is passed through the outlet, and thus we can obtain the pure water in a large scale. So that is the principle behind the automatic water distillator. This is a picture of a multiple still which is used to manufacture purified water in large scale. Now let us see the properties of water. It is clear, colorless, tasteless, and odorless liquid. The specific gravity is 1 at 25 degrees Celsius. The boiling point is 100 degrees Celsius. The freezing point is 0 degree. Refractive index is 1.33. pH is 5.8 to 7. Now the impurities of water, there are two types of impurities which can be seen in water, that is insoluble and soluble. So insoluble impurities are clay, sand, plant or animal waste, industrial waste, and the microbial contaminations, microbes or bacteria or fungus. Now the soluble impurities are, there are non-volatile and volatile impurities. Non-volatile impurities are chloride, carbonate, bicarbonate, sulfate of sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, and iron. Now the volatile impurities are carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfate, ammonia, nitric oxide, sulfur dioxide. So these are the volatile impurities. Now let us see the impurity test for common impurities which is present in a water. So the common impurities are chloride. So the reagent to identify chloride is silver nitrate and dilute nitric acid. When the reagent is added, if chloride is present, then there is a presence of white turbidity in the water. And another impurity is calcium. To detect calcium in the water, add ammonium oxalate and dilute acetic acid. If calcium is present, there will be a formation of white turbidity. Now the next impurity is sulfate. To detect sulfate in the water, add barium chloride and dilute HCl. If sulfate is present, there is a formation of white turbidity in the solution. Now the last one is ammonia. The reagent for ammonia is Nestle's reagent. And if ammonia is present in the water, there is a formation of brown precipitate. These are the common impurity tests employed to detect the impurities in water. Now, homeopathic uses. It is used to prepare aqueous mother solution. So aqueous mother solutions are the mother solutions which are soluble in water, the water medium. It is also used as a menstruum in new method of mother tincture preparation. So water is known as a universal solvent, and another universal solvent is alcohol. When you mix alcohol and water, it becomes a perfect solvent for almost all the vegetable and animal drug substance. It is used to convert solid titration into liquid potency, and this process is known as jumping potency or fluxion potency. It is used to prepare mother solution for 50 millismol potency. It's also used for dispensing homeopathic medicine and placebo. The medicine can be dispensed in water. It is used as an ingredient for many external applications, especially the lotions. It is used to prepare different strength of alcohol by diluting it with alcohol with purified water. It is used for cleaning utensils. So these are the important uses of purified water or distilled water in homeopathic pharmacy. Thank you all.